Hey, sports fans, back at it again, and this time we are here to talk all things former Alabama quarterback and current Miami Dolphins quarterback Tua Tagovailoa. The fifth pick in the 2020 NFL Draft appears fast on his way to NFL stardom after taking the reins from Ryan Fitzpatrick and looks poised to do the same things we saw on the field for Saban and the Crimson Tide. But these are things you probably already know. Today, we're going to take a look at the 10 things you didn't know about Tua Tagovailoa. Before we get into that, do me a favor. Click that subscribe button. Got it? Good. On to our list. Number 10. Tua's real name is a lot longer than Tua. Tua Tagovailoa is actually Tua Niamualepola. I don't know. I can't even pretend that I can pronounce that. So it's a real mouthful, and so you can see why it's shortened to Tua. As you can imagine, growing up, Tua had scores of people mispronounce his name, so that change was primarily for them. When asked about the name change, Tua usually responds with a smile and an anecdote about someone messing up his name, but it seems Tua takes it lightly. At the end of the day, it doesn't seem like Tua minds too much. Could you imagine Tua time being Tua Niamualepola time? I can't. Thank you, Tua. Appreciate it. Number 9. Tua spent $1.65 million on a Miami mansion. What would you do if you were given $30 million? That question became a reality for the 22-year-old signal caller out of Alabama when the ink dried on his rookie deal. He decided to buy himself a mansion in suburban Davie, Florida, not that far from the Miami Dolphins practice facility. Compared to some NFL players' first big contract purchases, Tua's $1.65 million isn't actually that crazy. The 5,200-square-foot property is large, but not gargantuan. It has 6 bedrooms and has a very nice pool. The place also comes equipped with spectacular views and his own $30,000 gym. Tua, who is said to be somewhat of a homebody, has quite the place to hunker down. Number 8. Tua's father forced him to throw with his left hand in an age where most quarterbacks are right-handed. Tua's dad decided it was going to be best for his son to be a lefty. It's been speculated that this was in case Tua ever became a pitcher, but Tua's father came out and said that he made Tua a lefty so that there would be 2 left-handers in the family. Yeah, Tua's dad is a lefty. He didn't want to be the only one. Although there are a few lefties that have had success in the NFL, like Steve Young, Michael Vick, Boomer Esiason, Tua is definitely in the minority as far as signal callers. Being a lefty hasn't stopped him this far, and many expect Tua to be mentioned up there one day with some of the better left-handed quarterbacks to ever play the game. Number 7. Tua was able to throw 30-yard passes at the age of 8. This one sounds a bit, kind of like a stretch, but when asked if it was true, Tua said, yes, it was a fact. When he was younger, he worked on both his arm strength and accuracy, and his father, who was also his trainer, wanted him to be able to throw both far and accurately. Back in those days, Tua's peers were struggling to throw at 10 yards, so when Tua was launching passes 30 yards with good accuracy for an 8-year-old, people began to take notice. Tua attributes his early passing success to his father and to all of the fathers out there. Tua's dad may be onto something. If Tua ever makes it to Canton, let's hope he elaborates on the lefty thing as well as being able to bomb a football 30 yards down the field, which is quite a feat of strength for a second or third grader. Number 6. At 14 years old, Tua almost quit football, but he continued to honor his grandfather. When Tua was 14 years old, his grandfather passed away. His grandfather also believed that he was going to grow up to be a football star. Tua, who had been wavering on quitting before his grandfather's passing, decided that the best thing he could do to honor his grandfather was to continue to play the sport he and his grandfather loved. We're sure he's making his grandfather proud, and fresh into his rookie season, the young quarterback has a lot of football left. Number 5. Tua's career was almost over. In 2019, while playing Mississippi State, Tua dropped back to pass like he always does, and he tried to make a play, like he did so routinely for the Crimson Tide during his college career. But after an awkward tackle, the sports world held its collective breath as Tua struggled on the ground, reportedly screaming in pain. As Tua was carted off the field, Alabama fans may have seen their season slipping away and driving through that tunnel to the locker room. Things looked about as grim as they could, and by the look on Tua's face, he knew his season was over at the very least. After word got out that it was a dislocated hip and a posterior wall fracture, not everyone was as optimistic as the team doctor, who said that Tua would make a full recovery. Many surgeons and specialists chimed in and said that due to blood flow issues and many other complications, including potentially never gaining full mobility of the hip again, that Tua may never play a down of pro sports. Tua had recovered from several injuries in his young career, but he had never suffered a setback like this. Many questioned if he should have even been in the game at that point. Crimson Tide had the game in the bag at halftime. People began questioning Saban's decision to keep Tua in the game, but after word got out that it was Tua's decision to stay in the game to get one more drive in, Saban was let off the hook. Tua attacked his rehabilitation with a mindset to return even better than before, and so far in his rookie season, the 22-year-old looks to have fully recovered from what almost derailed a promising career, and looks like he's well on his way. Number 4, Tua is the first Samoan quarterback to win a national title. This honor almost went to former Oregon Duck and Las Vegas Raider Marcus Mariota, who ended up falling shy of this feat. Although Mariota would go on to be the highest drafted Samoan quarterback in NFL history, it was Tua, who came in for the relief of Jalen Hurts and ended up leading the Tide to a comeback victory over Georgia. Tua tossed 3 touchdowns and was named offensive MVP of the game in a performance that introduced the name Tua Tagovailoa to the world and began the young Samoan's legend. Number 3, Tua was singing and playing the ukulele before his hip surgery. While family, friends, and, well, the football world were worried about what would happen to Tua after his surgery, it would appear that Tua wasn't overly concerned. If he was, at least he didn't show it. As family and loved ones gathered around Tua to keep his spirits up, Tua was filmed playing his ukulele and entertaining those that were there to cheer him up. It's said that one of Tua's biggest traits is that he doesn't buckle under pressure, and it would appear Tua just possesses a different level of calm than most. Judging from the video, he's also better than most at playing the ukulele and can definitely carry a tune. Number 2, Tua's brother Tualia was his backup in college. Wait, what? Being a college athlete is hard enough. Being at a program like Alabama, well, it's even harder. Having 2 brothers who are handling your starting and backup quarterback duties has got to be 1 in a million. The younger quarterback served as a backup in 2019 before transferring to Maryland. The former 4-star recruit committed to the Tide in 2018 and was looking forward to getting some playing time after his brother left the program. And when that didn't happen, he transferred to Maryland for a chance to compete for a starting job. Tailua's father said it was a tough decision for the young quarterback, but he claimed that his son is a competitive kid and didn't get a chance to really get in there and show Bama what he could do earlier in the year because of COVID, and made up his mind to seek playing time elsewhere. And number 1 on our list today of 10 things you didn't know about Tua. A tornado destroyed Tua's car. You heard that correctly. In March, while he was living and training in Nashville in preparation for the NFL draft, around 1 a.m., he woke up to his phone buzzing and several weather alerts going off. He said he also heard sirens outside a couple of minutes later. Tornado swept past the place he was staying at and destroyed his car that was sitting outside. Tua said the tornado that destroyed his car was just one of many incidents that made the offseason more challenging for him to go along with rehab, COVID, Zoom call meetings, and, well, needing new transportation. Don't cry for Tua. After signing his deal, he bought himself a Ford Flex and a BMW i8. Tua said he bought 2 cars so his family could have one to drive when they come visit. Being in Miami and already being a victim of a natural disaster, maybe he bought an extra one in case a hurricane destroys one of them. The former is probably true. While we're on cars, he also bought his mom a Cadillac Escalade. Alright fans, that wraps up our list on Tua Tagovailoa. 10 things up, 10 things down. Was there anything that we left off the list? What'd we miss? Anything that surprised you or seems too unbelievable to be true? Let us know by dropping us a line down in the comments, and if you haven't done so already, do us a favor. Hit that subscribe button so you can stay up to date on all our exciting football content. Until next time, sports fans. See ya!